I've nothing to wear to the party. I love a punctual man. How you doing, Steph? What's happening? Welcome, welcome. Catching up. Boom. Lamia, I got your message about the music volume. It unrelated to the change I made for the mic. How's the mic, by the way? How does that sound to you? Hey, Swiss, welcome. Welcome aboard. Yo, trying to catch up here. Yeah, K-Swiss, cool. Thought I saw that there. How's everyone? Got a couple tapes left. Let's get them going. We'll get back on some missions.
This war, the Kremlin never expected.
I love it when things go right
against the Mujahideen.
After going wrong.
Afghanistan is a tribal society.
Pulling something out of the fire.
Tradition demands that its people stand up to any outsiders who set foot on their land. With the honor of their people at stake, they have everything to fight for. No matter how hard the Soviets hit them, they continue to appear out of nowhere, striking back, then vanishing again. But there's one thing even the Mujahideen fear. Every last one of them. The Soviet gunships.
Message coming in.
They're highly maneuverable and equipped with massive firepower. Plus, the
underside
of the fuselage is heavily armored. The Mujahideen can barely scratch them with their small arms. Anyone who hangs around gets mowed down by the gunship's heavy machine guns. This new honeybee weapon that was given to the Hamid fighters, it's no doubt something to help them strike back against the gunships, which makes it a weapon that could change the course of the war.
I have detected a signal embedded
in the
Honeybee
is such a cool mission.
Fighters known as Mujahideen.
Derex, thank you for the follow. Welcome aboard.
Afghanistan is a multi-ethnic country. You've got the Pashtuns, the Tajiks, Uzbeks, Hazaras, and each of them is split into their own tribes, large and small. Each ethnicity has several rebel organizations that their various tribes gather under. They're united under the banner of jihad.
I like the tapes.
That doesn't mean they work like a single standing army. Just look at the area around Smossy Fort. A lot of Tajiks used to live there, but they fled after the Soviets started their scorched earth campaign. With the area uninhabited, the Hamid fighters, who are Pashtun, decided to move in. The Hamids are based out of the city of Peshawar. We passed through it on the western edge of Pakistan. The Pashtun people have long lived in Afghanistan and western Pakistan. They used to travel back and forth frequently. Then Britain went and established the border that still stands today. The Hamid fighters get generous support from the Pakistani government. The government wants to use them to secure influence over Afghanistan. Their liaison with the Hamids is Inter Services Intelligence, and behind the ISI, you have the CIA. That's probably how the honeybee ended up in the hands of the Hamid men.
C-Star, your BTTV emotes. They disappeared! Everybody picnic. Everybody picnic now.
Ocelot said the number of private forces is increasing, and they've modeled themselves after us. They're a far cry from the likes of us. But why? 9 years ago, we made enemies of the world as a nuclear-equipped force, independent of ideology or state.
Yes. Sooner or later, the real UN would have stepped in.
So why are they giving these PFs free rein?
That's our fault, too.
What do you mean?
What happened 9 years ago was a real problem for a lot of people. An organization as big as ours, with our facilities, was wiped off the map. Not an easy thing to hide. But if our existence came to light, so would the names of our clients. We had contracts all over, east and west, from superpowers to banana republics, the lot. Our clients denied all association with the likes of us. They had to make sure things didn't blow up on them. But at the same time, they missed us. They really missed us. The demand for armies for hire was as strong as ever. The international community turned a blind eye to what happened to us, despite still needing people who could do our jobs. History couldn't afford to lose us. As soon as we were gone, they needed a replacement. So private forces spread everywhere. And they're all just a phone call away.
But still.
I know. PFs are totally different from what we envisioned. Nation states, revolutionaries, terrorists. They have a lot of clients. And Cypher is one of them. Cypher stays anonymous.
Hey, Foamy. Redhead, thank you for the follow. Welcome aboard the Starship Chaos.
Good to have you here. The clients don't have to worry about losing their own men. Nobody knows they're involved, and PFs are cheap. In short, the world is chewing up soldiers and spitting them out. Even some of the old mother base's survivors are still working for PFs. Some guys created their own smaller forces. Others were taken on by emerging PFs. Everybody's gone their separate ways. But none of them are living their dream, because they're not fighting with you. Of course, I tried to headhunt as many of them as I could for Diamond Dogs. It was all a waste of time. They said they weren't interested without you to lead them. But now you're back.
I have detected a signal embedded in the static.
We'll unite
all aboard! Welcome.
And economies. What is a nation?
Bunzo!
A patch of dirt. The bonds among us will
call you Bunzo, or what can we call you? Welcome aboard. Cheers, thank you for the follow.
We'll establish a new kind of country. Redefine the very concept of it. Even Cypher will be below us. An extraterritorial federation of military nations. The United States of Force. Once word of Big Boss's return starts traveling, that'll be our true deterrent against Cypher. In other words, no one will dare to come gunning for you.
How do you figure?
Cypher lacks a large-scale fighting force. PFs are the perfect tool for them. But those PFs revere you, the legendary Big Boss. If Cypher killed you now, they wouldn't take it lying down. Maybe they'd even go looking for revenge, but they definitely wouldn't keep doing Cypher's dirty work, even if it put their lives at stake. That's why it's no longer a benefit to Cypher to get rid of you. The very fact that you're alive is our greatest defense against Cypher.
Nice to know. It'll buy us some time while we get back to full strength.
Just keep in mind that what I'm saying is generalizing a lot. In practice, the PFs around the world don't know your face. Just declaring that you're Big Boss won't be enough to convince them. And if they see you as an enemy, they'll come at you with everything they've got.
Some hero.
That's why you need to bring them back to Mother Base. Show them on your terms that you really are the one and only Big Boss. Once you've proven that, they won't hesitate to join us.
True. No, we're not. All right, what happened? The old Mother Base members. Ground Zeroes being just a brief little interlude. We basically got Peace Walker feeding directly into Phantom Pain. I mean, what happened in Ground Zeroes matters, but that was with tapes and cinematics. So, what happened to Chico? Sort of know what happened to Chico. What happened to Amanda? What happened to Strangelove? What happened to Huey? In a little bit now. We'll get more later. Terry, how you been? What's going on?
Yeah, I do.
Their revolution was a success.
Mike!
Resigned.
What's
up? Nicaragua has a new government. Amanda's really working hard for her country to be reborn.
Good for them.
Welcome, welcome, everyone.
She says she wishes Chico could be
there. How y'all doing?
That revolution was the dream. For Amanda. For Chico. And their father.
That chopper was no place for Chico to die. I'd like to at least think history will remember his part in the revolution.
When you pick up a gun, there's always a chance you'll die for nothing. He knew that as well as the rest. Now that he's gone, it's up to the rest of us to decide what it was all worth. If we don't, there's nothing to prove that Chico ever lived at all. We're his mark on the world.
Amanda told us that Strangelove contacted her after the revolutionaries came to power in Nicaragua. Strangelove, the AI researcher from Mother Base.
Awesome, Terry.
I remember her.
We'd lost touch with her, till Amanda heard from her out of the blue. She told Amanda she wanted to salvage Peace Walker's drive parts or something from the bottom of Lake Nicaragua. Amanda passed the request on to her friends in the new administration. She's a national hero now, after all. So Strangelove got a Soviet military aircraft to transport something to somewhere. But apparently the cargo wasn't big enough to have been Peace Walker itself.
So what was it?
Who knows? We recovered Peace Walker's nuclear warhead ourselves 9 years ago. What could Strangelove have been after? Amanda said she didn't mention what her reason was or where she was headed. Nicaragua is a socialist state now. With Amanda vouching for her, the government didn't feel the need to concern itself with the details. All Strangelove told Amanda was that she was going to continue her research, and that the rest was a secret. Right before the attack, Huey was in the control tower to prepare for the inspectors. He was with them when it all went down. The control tower collapsed with the rest of its strut. His body was never recovered. But he was the one who met the inspection party when they arrived. And he was the one who showed the nuclear inspectors to the tower. You remember the way it went. First he recommends we agree to the inspection. Then he gives them the okay without our permission. All the time acting as if he was doing us a favor. On top of that, he even had the guards disarmed that day. It would send the wrong message, he said. Whatever the angle, it all leads back to Huey. I curse my own stupidity for not realizing sooner. Huey escaped with that unit by chopper. I've been hunting him for 9 long years. The other reason I was operating around Afghanistan was to dig up his location.
Huey's in Afghanistan?
Yes. And I have a good idea where.
Get him!
Now we just wait for the right moment. This time, we'll be the ones using him. He's going to tell us who our guests really were that used a fake nuclear inspection to blast our home into the ocean.
You don't want me to accidentally snipe him? Last guy. Hey, good times. Yeah, welcome to Twitch. You here, very cool. Well, Soul is great. You landed in a couple good places to start off. Derek, yeah, Metal Gear Solid 4 not only has 9 hours of cutscenes, that the total 9 and something, but has the longest single cutscene.
You.
Grab that during the last mission? Must have happened so fast. We'll play more music while running some missions. Achieved an Intel tapes played rate of 10. Or unit leveled up.
Development project has been added.
Upgrade the Fulton device. Already. There's so many giveaways. Giveaways.
Please specify a project.
Upgraded Fulton portable ammo up, meaning more Fulton devices permission without calling for resupply. Ah, never mind. I don't want you to drop me, Fulton.
Please specify a project.
So, what do you want to do? Side ops, we don't have many unlocked yet. We'll have tons. Soon enough, we'll have tons. Eventually, we'll be repeating them. Sadly, the game doesn't just repeat. Side ops will eventually be repeating main ops. Don't have to worry about that for now. Let's do them in order. Over the fence, extract the engineer who tried to defect from a Soviet base camp and is now being held at Waxin Barracks. 6, where do the bees sleep? Now, that's probably the first super cool mission, and it ties into the next bit of plot and has some cool cinematics, but we'll just go in order. Track the engineer who tried to defect.
Please, the landing zone.
Roger.
Got our shower? We're back at base?
This is B-Squad. Arriving shortly at LZ.
For the most part, what is the point of upgrading the helicopter just costs more per delivery? A few things. It will arrive faster, that's the helicopter itself, and then you've got things like armor and weaponry. So if you call in support strikes, if you want the helicopter to actually attack things, you want it to be more survivable, and you want it to do more damage, but it does cost more. So if all you want is a basic pickup, you may not want to upgrade it at all, or you may only want to upgrade the basic helicopter so it gets there faster, but don't worry about other things. If your helicopter is getting blown up when you call it in because you like to call it into dangerous areas, You might want some armor. It might be worth spending. But if you don't change it, you're going to spend that money every time you call. Either micromanage it or spend a lot. Keep it pretty basic. Own way. Thanks for the broken nose, boss.
Side ops list updated.
The mission nightmare level
updated.
In Snake Eater. Oh, the sorrow of that. Okay, I gotcha, if that's what you meant. I know there's Sigint's nightmare. Construct more platforms. One or more units has reached maximum staff capacity. By building more of the relevant unit platforms, your base will be able to house more staff. In terms of resources, what do we have? Requires fuel 1,000, fuel 1,000, fuel. Not a whole lot. Had all this huge GMP boon, and this allows us to take our teams up to larger sizes, so better ranked team. Eventually we'll get better people to be on those teams.
Commencing platform construction.
We can get all the platforms underway as long as we have the resources and money. Here's my, it says required. Where does it show how much I have?
Commencing platform construction. Commencing platform construction. Commencing platform construction.
Awesome. A lot already showing up here. It says 2%, but there's a lot already showing up here. We haven't seen things. I don't know. Why do they show with question marks? I would assume because we hadn't seen them yet, but then we've got things that we haven't seen yet that are not shown with question marks. List of the wild animals you have taken in. Is this cumulative? I deleted my save data. Did it pull this off of some online server? I wonder. Are these all available, or are these just all the ones that I get? Have all of these already? AJ, Uncharted 4 is only on PS4, and it is fantastic. This looks like it reset. Posters reset, photos, all that stuff reset. Either the animals did or didn't reset. I don't know why there would be so much on there already. Side ops, main ops. Let's go back and forth.
Please select a mission.
For the moment, over the fence.
Mission accepted. Heading to Afghanistan.
Couple choices of where to land the helicopter. Sometimes that has a big difference on the outcome of the mission, on where you're approaching from and the outcome of the mission. I want to change the logo too. It says Diamond Dogs, that's fine, but
deploying.
Customize it. What's that? Lord Phoenix, what's going on? What was not working? Was it the emotes?
Heading
Tyler, you say, of course, GameCube, but I had one of those.
You need to find him and get him out. He tried to defect from the base camp up north, but it didn't work out. Now they're holding him at Watson. He's offered his technical skills to us as long as we can guarantee his safety. You have to extract the target.
Your target just happens to be the man who developed your prosthetic hand, and he's the only one capable of maintaining it. If we bring him in, I'm sure
I got you, Tyler. Well, that's cool. I love the handle. Love how simple it was.
Be careful down there, boss.
I only kept a couple of my GameCube games. I did sell my GameCube, but I kept the Ocarina of Time on the tiny little disc that I got when I bought. I don't know why. Did I get that?
Golden Crescent. It's a type of medicinal plant. We can use that to make tranquilizer rounds more potent.
Analysis complete.
Expand Mother Base. We need more manpower. And not just for combat roles either. R&D, the support unit, intel, each demands a different set of skills. If we want to achieve what we've set out to do, Diamond Dogs has got to get stronger. There's a Soviet engineer I want to have join us. He was the one who built your prosthesis. With him on our side, who knows what sort of enhancements he'll come up with for it. He tried to defect, but didn't make it, and now he's being held prisoner at Waxin Barracks. Find this engineer and get him out. Having him on our R&D team will go a long way to helping Diamond Dogs grow.
I love the Fox Engine. Works so well.
That's communications equipment used by the outpost CP. It must be how they keep in touch with headquarters. If you destroy it, you might be able to cut off the CP from their HQ.
Want to make that a priority throughout this playthrough. Doesn't have to happen every mission, but I'd like to destroy as much comm equipment as possible.
Somewhere inside that outpost. The Soviets consider him a traitor now, so he'll be treated like any other prisoner.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Oh, that's right. You were at the Razor event today. Lord Phoenix. Gotta help him packing up. Turning back to Germany. Oh, you got a Firefly. Sweet. Man, well, tell us a little more. Forgot you were going to that. That's really cool. I bet you're pretty excited. At the risk of starting a silly discussion, I'll bite AJ. The hardware between the two systems is more similar than it's ever been. The way the software is developed for each one is not. So, as is, they can't run each other's software. And it will not happen that they will ever make them compatible. But in theory, one could be made to run the other. There just isn't software in place to do that. The hardware is very similar. It's never been more similar. I hear a tape. Tape, but not the, not a music tape. There are a few other, a lot of, I think that's a tape we can't grab, is what I'm. Who else is around here? I'm still not used to the amount of bullet drop that exists anymore. Get used to firing a little above people's heads at certain distances, and I don't know, I think I'll get used to it. 71 meters. I don't think I can hit anyone with this pistol from 71 meters. Also don't know that there are or aren't people around. Pick up these lights. Alert anyone. But you know why? Because I got lucky. Really didn't check first. That. No! God, snake! Oh! Jeez. That was perfect. We have a document here? Grab it, please.
On the target. I've updated your map info. Check it on your iDroid.
Soldiers in Phantom Pain will often hear and see, especially see, their fellow soldiers being taken up by Fulton. I wonder what's going on. 50 meters, I think we're good. And 80 meters, I think we're.
He's coming too. Roger that.
How has my map actually changed? We've got some details about where to find this guy. We would not want to mess around with clearing the base if we were going for, say, an S rank. Oh, his head hit the lamp. Oh, that is the best. Look at that! His head! You heard it. You heard it, right? His head hit the light. Now it's pointing at the sky. It's calling for Batman. That's...
You have arrived at your destination.
I need to climb this to get C4 to work. Let's call it an experiment. Put the C4 on the ground instead of on the equipment itself. I think that's sufficient. Seventy-eight meters, which means the guy's only about like 30, 40 meters past these lights. Let's see if he notices when I take him out. Not. There's a diamond on the ground. Get it. Tyler, that'll work with it on the ground. What's that, Tyler? Used to get spotted a lot trying to get up on those. Just dropped them and ran out. Oh, up on the, for radio equipment. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Get spotted trying to climb up on them. I think I have investigated blowing them up, but I'm really rusty, so. Chi, what's happening? Welcome, Chi. How are you? It's fun to be playing Phantom Pain again.
Too. Roger that.
No, shh, you loudmouth. What are we doing? Are we restarting to checkpoints from checkpoints? What are we doing? It's a main mission. Are we doing the checkpoint thing? We were talking about that yesterday. Snask, what's going on? Is Ground Zero similar to Phantom Pain in gameplay? It is, but slightly different. Different types of things to do, but still the same type of feel to it. Yeah, exactly. Get a good basic sense of it. Checkpoint, continue. I'm fine with either one. First playthrough, I did not do a lot of reloading from checkpoints. This is a third playthrough. More open-minded. No takers? We can checkpoint it. I'm fine with running off, trying to get back into stealth, going Rambo on everyone from time to time. But I don't have an actual plan, so anything goes. Iceman, how's it going? I think I saw you there already. Don't think I said hello. How are you doing? And yeah, checkpoint. It's cool. Let's do it. Let's try and get some cleaner runs. What happened to the guy in the post? Loaded from a checkpoint. Instead of being up there, he's down here.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
I got his buddy in the back. Great. Like I said, I don't have a good feel for the bullet drop yet. I suppose they'll know that the equipment is blown up, even if no one's around to hear it, see it. They know, like their network will show.
He's coming too. Roger that.
Meters. If I use anything explosive here right now, I can still plant the C4. But if I use anything explosive here now. It will hear that from 80 meters. What is? I'm gonna get shit for even asking this. What is Rising right now? Is Rising on sale at the moment? About the only one I don't have. Haven't played. Right now. Could I ask good night? Well, we'll see you later. See you tomorrow. let's find out a little bit about the AI here. They are 30 meters away. So they're about 40 meters away from this lamp. Come on, Snake. Don't hump the rock now. See if they care from 30 meters away. 30, 40 meters away. They didn't notice. They didn't care. They don't remember that, but noted. From a Zelda game?
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
But he saw that go down.
Analysis complete.
Oh God. Sounds are gone.
So your suppressor is worn out. That gun will be as loud as any other now. If you have to shoot, be careful.
God, everywhere. All right, I know where he is. I didn't even think of where I was, though. Thank you.
anti-air radar? It wasn't one of the targets, and that's put a hole in their air surveillance. The chopper will be able to get in close now. You can designate a landing zone near the outpost.
Go faster! How many do I have left? 14, great. Nearly as well as I expected it to. That's too bad.
Boss, you've entered a building. Keep an escape route in mind when you head indoors. If you get surrounded, you'll have nowhere to run.
Oh, nice. Impressive. Pistol? Oh shit, that was noisy. I forgot I didn't have a suppressor. You cannot take out a light with the Trank pistol. It's too bad. You're gonna tell me he's too fragile to be Fulton, too.
Great. If there's nothing in the way overhead, you should be able to Fulton him.
No? Get a wonderfully terrible rating on this mission.
Target extraction confirmed. Your objective's complete. Exfiltrate out of the hot zone by chopper or on land.
Break in, break out. He's just busting windows. Oh, that's C4. Here, come play. Please, please come play. Please come play. It's irresistible. Come on, I accidentally dropped that on the ground. Come see if I'm here. Do like breaking the windows. Oh, phantom pain. I'm sorry this one did not turn out stealthy at all, but I do kind of like where it's gone. Let's go out the window because window. There we go. Oh, now I'm happy. Doors? What are these doors? What are these doors you speak of? Happened to the
he's coming too.
Thought I blew up the comm equipment. Radios. Oh god, this dude is still here. Oh no, 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 don't die because you're picking someone up. That would be stupid. Terrible reason. Come check. See if I'm here. Sure, you want to check? Come check. Maybe I'm not here anymore. I think you better check. Oh god, I was gonna rescue those guys. I guess we won't be rescuing those guys. Uh-oh.
Extraction failed.
Okay, two guys. I killed two guys. It happened. Rest of them get to come back to Mother Base. But I was out of... I guess I was not completely out of non-lethal weapons. Just my silencer was...
He's coming too. Roger that.
Oh, the Riot SMG, the non-lethal SMG. Now we've got something to develop.
Please specify a project.
Rockets for the helicopter. helicopter will cost more to deploy, but it'll be able to kick some ass. Just a little bit. A little bit of ass. Okay, sandstorm has cleared. Let's get a pickup.
Please select support helicopter. Roger. Requested.
Pickup can be right here because we cleared the anti-aircraft radar. Here. Start Fultoning mortars and things for Mother Base too. The score will look like.
Departing.
Took a long time, took a lot of hits, killed a couple people. It's not gonna be a pretty score.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Development project has been added.
Mission complete.
B. Well, it could have been worse. Could have been worse. Alerts, hits. Then we annihilated the whole camp. Bum, ba, bum. One of the cool things about taking out all the comm equipment early in the game when you're running these missions, and I'm sort of guessing at this based on what I saw later game, is that the comm equipment will not respawn. So back through these places later. Not all of them will be revisited in missions, but some of them will. And having comm equipment already gone, having some extra landing zones, it could be fun and useful. Chick, I'm your chick.
The engineer we rescued has been extremely cooperative. The guys on the R&D team are glad to have him aboard. Thing is, his specialty isn't mechanics, but something called bionics, engineering based on biology. He's already submitted a proposal for modifying your prosthetic arm. If you're interested, go ahead and give the development order.
Wondering what the fastest route to weapon customization is. You need the right specialist. So that's the bionic specialist. Gunsmith, assault rifles, lots of different gunsmiths, but we need the right person to be able to customize weapons. That's when we'll be able to put a silencer on the variation of the Renov that we don't have yet. When we get the Trank variation of the Renov, be able to put a silencer on it. Wouldn't mind planning ahead though, getting that as soon as possible.
Please specify a project.
You're missing. I don't even have a combat unit yet. Electro spinning specialist. D-Horse will be able to get some better armor. Legendary Gunsmith. Thank you, C-Star. That's the one. Legendary Gunsmith. He has a mission, a side op that appears, and then there is or was some sort of bug or intended feature where that side op would disappear. I don't know why. Element another mission? Did something happen? Anyways, the side op, I think it's like 29, after mission 13, it says, whatever it is, the legendary gunsmith side op shows up, and if we see it, we're going to jump on it. We got to do that right away. Because during the first playthrough, I don't think anyone wants to take the time to go digging it up. But somewhere in there, you can see it on the side op menu and then gone. And we talked about it. Where did it go? Where did the legendary gunsmith go? And it wasn't until much later that we had the opportunity to do that again. Tunnel Snake, what's happening? Welcome back. Stopping power up. C4 gets stronger. We're still at the stage where the development of these items is instantaneous. Game gave us 13 million. Guess we'll just stay on top of it for now. We won't be able to keep this list clean forever. There will eventually be millions and millions and millions of GMP worth of things to make that we can't afford. Привет! Привет! The helicopter. What do we want to do with it? Armor? I want armor and.
Please specify a project.
Maybe the third tier. That it comes really quickly. Won't have armor until our R&D team is almost triple the size it is now. Anybody on auto assignment? Must be, because there's nobody in the waiting room and we've been bolting people. Grabbing everyone I could find. A few specialists. I think most of the A ranks came out of the rewards. Pretty sure most of the people we're faultoning in missions are E, D, C, and the occasional B. RoboCop, what's going on? Doing great, how are you? Settling back into Phantom Pain. One tape on the bionic arm.
We were lucky to get our hands on that cyborg arm developer. There's no one in Diamond Dogs who can so much as maintain that thing.
Bionic arm, not cyborg, if you go by what he calls it. But you're right, the East is light years ahead in bionics. They can even detect through the skin the slight electrical signals from the brain that order muscles to move. The Soviet Union completed their first bionic arm capable of doing that back in the 60s. Although I guess that news didn't really reach the West.
No kidding. Zadornov's was the only one I ever saw. Quite a shock to see it for the first time.
And it was no mean feat to get hold of Snake's arm. I couldn't get one for you at the time, but you know, now...
Forget it. I've no intention of relying on bionics. Right now, I need to keep the pain fresh in my mind.
Well, it's your decision. But don't you find it inconvenient?
Not a bit. But the Phantom Pain. It never lets up. Do you know how many men I saw die that day? There's nothing we can do to bring them back. And you expect me to care about getting a measly arm and leg back?
Calm it down, Kaz.
Sorry. But my pain belongs to all our dead comrades. I'll keep living with it for their sake. It'll guide me straight and true until I've gotten them the vengeance they deserve.
What's next? E-sleep or stay caught up on side ops. Let's at least do one side op in between main ops, if nothing else. Got where we just were. Secure the Riot SMG blueprint. Just get that.
Please start development. The landing zone.
Using. Troy, what's happening, man? Hey, good to see you. Yes, higher grade versions. What you been up to, man? You and the family doing all right? Yeah. All right, getting messages. About time for another shower, boss. What about sneaking suit? SV sneaking suit. I'm still curious, does anyone know, is that because I downloaded the Ground Zero save data, which I had never done before? I wasn't sure why that showed up right away for development.
Deploying.
Everyone is excellent. Awesome. Awesome. Very glad to hear it. I know some people got tired of hearing the awesome Peace Walker theme on the battle prep, mission prep screen. And they do kind of, it is overplayed because it's there every time, but it is so awesome. I hope I didn't ruin it for anyone. Oldest graduated high school, heading to college, spending as much time as possible in the pool. Swimming sounds really nice. Gudgeon, think it was for the Ground Zero save. Kim, you checked it out too? Perfect. I'll take it. Having a sneaking suit up front. Where they were. That's where the intel was when they were holding Kaz. Came for intel.
That's tarragon, a type of medicinal plant. It contains trace amounts of a benzodiazepine derivative that's the active ingredient in pentazamine.
Tarragon? Benzodiazepines in it? I did not know that.
Otherwise known as Soma.
Is that true?
People use it to make a sacred drink for religious ceremonies.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Marker placed.
Another side op at this location for a sheep. Maybe we don't have it yet. Really does. Troy, I love the engine. The Fox engine is amazing. Now, when this game came out, and then we were all blown away by the Fox engine, if nothing else, and the falling out with Konami, Kojima-san, we joked about how if Konami really wanted to say F you to the fans of the series, they would make a Fox Engine Metal Gear pachinko game. Guess what they're doing?
analysis complete.
Oh yeah, Troy, you gotta go see it. They've made a Snake Eater. They've remastered a number of the cutscenes from Snake Eater in the Fox Engine for a pachinko game. Lord Phoenix.
The security forces must know something about the targets. After you grab or hold up an enemy, try interrogating them.
Plan. At risk to your own sanity, Troy, you could Google that and check it out. It's pretty scary.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
I'm sure you're coming. Are you coming this way? Is the truck actually coming right by us? I hope not. RoboCop, I saw the brief Death Stranding preview.
He's coming too.
Where's the blueprint? Roger, it should that. Be marked now. I have gun emplacement. I had where it was, so why isn't it? Shouldn't it be marked? Oh, completely forgetting. When we're at different locations and we see these orange spots, delivery spots, we need to collect the delivery orders and then we'll be able to get dropped off at these spots if we want. What do you think? 50 meters? Meters? Oh, he's moving. Meters. Tiny bit of bullet drop. Bang! There you go, Tyler. They said finest in the industry. There's only a few possibilities.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
I think we already have this plan, so how do we get credit for the side op if I already have the plan, the blueprint? Maybe I don't. I could have sworn I already started development on the thing we're here for the blueprint for. Riot SMG, thought it was. Nice couch.
Hey,
No, they do. Gee, they do. They just have to be a little closer to it. They will totally notice the balloons going up into the sky. What they don't see is the helicopter that ostensibly is picking them up. Nor do we. And the helicopter makes no noise because it doesn't really exist. The idea is that there's a helicopter picking up all those balloons. And if you are close enough when you try to Fulton someone, they will definitely notice. Yeah, seriously, Spider. The only excuse given is that it's more financially sustainable. They don't actually talk about how a helicopter can safely, with its blades, grab a balloon. The actual Fulton system, there's some videos of it on YouTube that are very cool, the tests. Crazy, crazy stuff. How are you doing, Spider? Welcome, welcome. Everybody check out the bearded Spider if you don't know him already on Twitch. Give him a follow. So, problem. We were sent here for blueprints. Do we actually have a marker that suggests those blueprints still exist? Ah, there we go. There it is. It's a check mark.
Marker placed.
Cool. It's all about the bees. Buzz, buzz, buzz. I'm good. Spider, I'm good. I love playing Phantom Pain. Pretty much, regardless of the outcome of any mission, it's just fun to play.
That's used to make your Phantom cigars. There's sheep around. With the local residents gone.
Here, let me Fulton this sheep. Buzz, buzz, buzz. You almost played this game, then Rebel disappeared. Rebel. One day, man. Spider, he's gonna show up one day. One day. I don't know when it's gonna happen. I just walked by my marker, didn't I? And it disappeared. It's gotta be
side op complete. Material. List updated.
It could be just what we need to develop new weapons and equipment.
Plant expansion complete. Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Yep, it was. Yeah. S7 triggered that. Ember Jones, what's going on? You've been busy, it's all right. Hope things are all right with you.
Black carrot.
You've been up to?
Something of an ancestor to the domestic carrot. It's also a favorite of wild animals. There are goats around. The local residents gone,
yes, check out the goats. I guess we're done. Where to? There's more resources I didn't pick up. Let's head back to that spot, grab the rest of the resources that are on the map. Oh, they're there. Gotta be someone still around. I'm just running with impunity, but there's got to be someone here. Someone's gonna see me at some point. Hmm. Summer classes for school. Helping sister with her kids. Glad you're getting things taken care of. Oh god. Get used to jumping off of things. I'm thinking enough about whether it's safe. Hard habit to break. I can quite jump up there, so let's... I went right over the building. Come on now. There you go. Already blew it. E. Lopez, what's going on? Well, you know, maybe there is Novo, but I'll tell you what, we have a fantastic Afghani restaurant here in town I haven't been to recently. I'm dying to go back to. Called Maza Kebab. Maza Kebab. Oh man, they have an eggplant dish. They have a few incredible dishes there. You're just thinking about it.
Removed. Marker
placed. So we've got two resources right here that I missed.
You have arrived at your destination.
Bull! What's going on, Bull?
You have arrived at your destination.
Doing, bud? What's happening? Out of here. A rank, A rank, A plus rank. Formed 100 total markings.
Development project has been added.
Development requirements meant sneaking suit. We're wearing a sneaking suit. Ground zeros. Riot SMG. I could have sworn we already had that under development when we did this site up. Blueprint. R&D up to 14.
Project has been added.
And there's a truck coming. Should we have some fun with them? What can we do here? Hold on. Shit, shit. Oh, he didn't get close enough. That's not going to earn me any heroism. Damn it. Well, shit, you guys get to live. On the plus side for you guys. This is a snake! Snake, please. Tears, just dreams.
Extraction arrived at mother base.
All right. Checkpoint. We can pop back out. To avoid spending money on option to just pop backwards. Turn to ACC. Instead of calling for a helicopter every time, which costs you money, get outside the combat zone, finish your side op, get credit for it, and just return to the ACC. All mission progress since the last checkpoint will be lost. So, checkpoint, then do it. You don't have to spend all your GMP on calling in your helicopter every time to pick you up. Which is fun to go running after your side ops Pequod, list but... updated.
Please specify a project.
This is already, it's a non-lethal assault rifle. It does not have a suppressor, though. Big on weapons that are both non-lethal and have suppressors. Developing the Renov, continuing to develop that is important because we want the Trank variation and then the legendary gunsmith so we can put... and put a suppressor on it. The difference between the sneaking suit I have and the sneaking suit that I deserve. I don't know, the one that's here. Mines, better smoke grenades. Yep, 17.5 hour stream, Wombat. Finished, finally. Finally, finally. Jupiter's Jesus, how are you doing? Yield the Grom. I like the Grom. One of these, I can't remember which one it is, but one of these shotguns, you get a non-lethal variation on it. I don't know what the difference is, but let's develop it anyways. Misted Monkey! What's going on, Monkey? Aid launcher. Yeah. We'll have some missions to destroy tanks. We'll eventually use a group. A few target practice missions have shown up. I tried to do all those target practice missions once on my own, and I had to look up two of them, one of them, maybe two of them, definitely one, on YouTube to figure out how to find all of the targets. Might have been the R&D platform. One of them was a real pain. To extract the little lost sheep. That's in the same place we were just at. If I had not returned to the ACC, I could have done that and just walked right back in, found the right sheep, and left. I could be confusing the snipers, Monkey. It could be the is it M2000, R2000? It could be that sniper that you're talking about rather than the Rankov that I need to update to non-lethal. I might just have him confused. Oh, we gotta go extract the lost little sheep. A landing zone. Two sneaking suits, the SV, Ground Zeroes, and the other one, which has a higher rank, costs more to deploy. Noise dampening soles, eliminate sound of footsteps. This also has a high-strength aramid weave that offers superb damage resistance. So, the sneaking suit that you develop seems to be better than the sneaking suit that carries over. Also, looks bulkier. That could be too. C-Star, some of the side ops might not even appear till we get back to the ECC. Amber Jones, dinner just got there. And the family are going to watch a movie. Hey, much love. Take care. Have a good time with the family. Have a great dinner. I'm getting hungry. RoboCop, take care. See you later, have fun. We also need to go back to Mother Base. See if Dee Dee has grown up at all. Sounds weird, but Dee Dee might have grown up a little bit already. We also need to check back time to time just to keep things progressing. If we don't go back to Mother Base, there are various consequences. But after this side up, before we do anything else, let's go back to Mother Base and check in. Take a shower. For a sheep. I remember getting frustrated by overthinking this the first time. Sheep is or can be in one of the pens. I've got the sheep penned up. But I went looking for a
analysis complete.
A wild sheep somewhere, and I just got all worked up.
That's the target.
There it is. so many free staff members that are better than the ones we're picking up right now.
Please select a landing zone. Heading to Mother Base.
Jupiter's Jesus. Sea Star, have a great night. Well, see you later. Jupiter's Jesus, are you taking off as well? Look who it is. Hey, DD, come back.
Welcome home, boss. Boss, we're ready to develop new equipment. Just... Why'd the boss's old organization get taken out? Just because the U.S. didn't like having a threat like that on his doorstep?
You hear all kinds of stories. But from what Commander Miller says, there's more to it than that. They had this feud with an American covert intelligence agency called Cypher. During the Peace Walker incident, the boss built a merc outfit that fought alongside the Sandinistas. An army without a country. By mercs, for mercs. Something with no government holding the reins. Cypher wanted their military muscle, but the boss said no.
So they moved on the Caribbean base and massacred them.
Huh. I hear ya.
Cooperbound, what's happening? Because Metal Gear. Why does it seem like everyone and everything is missing an eye? Because they are. Antic Dingo.
Please, the landing zone.
Roger.
Edie's still too small to come along.
Arriving shortly at LZ.
Worst coworker award.
This is Pequod. On station at LZ.
Randomly tranquilizes his coworkers. at some point, need to explore even the parts of the base that we already have. There's some diamonds laying around, some extra GMP. We could also wait until we have more of the base built. Good, everybody good. R&D's at 14, almost full. Base development, support. Time for main op. Looking, actually, let's not do a main op quite yet because it's time for a break in a few minutes. Let's do one more side op, short side op, take a break, come back. When we come back, we've got one of the cool first big missions for the story, which is Where Do the Bees Sleep? Recover the U.S. military's new weapon, codenamed Honeybee, hidden at Smase Fort. Soviets are also after it. This can go pretty quickly. You can kind of get in fast, get the Honeybee, and get the heck out. If we take our time, this can be a long mission. I don't know how it's gonna go. Nice, Lumia, I forgot about that too. So that'll be first order of business when we get back from a break. Let's do a side up. Yeah, something small. Extract highly skilled soldier.
Select a landing zone.
Get it checked off as having been done at least once. Landing zone, not actually nearby.
Heading to Afghanistan.
Yeah. Want to customize the logo?
Deploying.
Change it to a J or something. I am hungry. I'm really hungry. I actually feel mentally fated. Had a burger today. All I've had. After the stream, I'm actually gonna cook something good, so I don't quite know what I'm gonna do during the break. I just am hungry now, but I'm gonna cook a steak proper after the break, so.
Be careful down there, boss.
This area here, there is a mission later on where we have to destroy a bunch of tanks. It takes place in this area. They're traveling from up here this way and vice versa. See these bridges. Actually, a lot of different terrain. There's some... I don't know. There's hills and valleys. Highs and lows. Hard to get around there. And that tank mission is pretty tricky to... I've heard it's one of the hardest to S-rank. I don't think I ever S-ranked that one. It's not what we're doing now, but at some point, yeah, we'll be in the same area.
Extraction arrived at the multibase. Analysis complete.
Yeah.
Did not describe that very well, but what happens is you have vehicles traveling by road, and at best you've got a horse. You can steal vehicles or bring a vehicle, but realistically, you're probably on horseback. And the very first time I tried to do that, I didn't even have D-Horse with me. I tried to do the mission on foot and ended up chasing on foot after vehicles, tanks, and trucks. And it's a timed mission. It has a countdown. You don't have to do too much within the timer, but you have to do something. And I managed to fail it by spending the whole time running back and forth on foot after motorized vehicles. Don't do that.
Analysis complete.
Bring a horse. Outside the zone, I don't think any of those. None of those are the guy we're looking for. Maybe he is back there. There's the little outpost just outside the area. Skill. Do you think I have a sniper sitting up somewhere? This is the very first soldier extraction. Expected it to be slightly more obvious soldier we were looking for, but it isn't. We're nearly at the edge of the area, though. Let's set up a couple markers.
Marker placed.
See if we can't find him. He's highly skilled at hiding. Well, we definitely want him. That's just... D-Horse, that's a little freaky. There he is. There's our highly trained soldier. Two of them, in fact. It's a little weird. Thought someone... Looking for... Hey, Chuko. What's up? This is the very first highly trained soldier side op. I've only seen three people. They were outside the area and they were not the highly trained soldier. Hiding in a box, huh? And then we definitely want him. There we go. Sniper! Told ya. I had a memory of it being a sniper. Still gonna get him. Okay. Looking at all the wrong cliff faces. Climb that. Bye. Pro tip, drink heavily. Suspend your disbelief on box camo. Yeah, you gotta go with what works. Ghillie suit in the desert. Yep. Got a checkpoint after the side op completed, right? I should be able to go right back to the ACC.
Cause it is break time.
Break time! Yeah, Iceman, mine are still working, but I have just been in the same browser session for quite a while on my chat laptop. So I don't know what's going on, if it's a BTTV thing.
Side ops themselves. List updated.
Hot dogs, yo! What's going on? Bat. I'm gonna take a break. We'll come back to where do the bees sleep. I'll see y'all in 10 minutes.